Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, this is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Wednesday, June 3rd, 2009. Not a lot of new data points from Tuesday's trading activity, fairly quiet. In the pre-market on Wednesday, we're looking at the futures lower across the board. European markets are lower. We've got crude oil and gold down in the pre-market on Wednesday. Now, Canadian dollar, following this really closely, we are up at testing 93 at the moment. We're down in the pre-market on Wednesday. We need a daily close below 88.10 to give us a new sell signal right now. Looking at the U.S. dollar, it's finding support down at 78.13. That is also not only a daily target, but a weekly target. We need a daily close above 81 on the U.S. dollar index to give us a new daily buy signal. Looking at gold, it's up pretty close to 1,000. Remember, 1,000 is the exit, not the start of anything. It's the end of a move. We need a daily close below 955 right now to give us a new daily sell signal. A lot more activity in the silver market. We need a daily close below 1480 right now to give us a new sell signal in silver. Looking at copper, had that big spike on Monday, didn't do anything on Tuesday, closed lower. We need a daily close below 283. Looking at crude oil, up at 68.75, which is our next target after we pass through the 62.50 area. We need a daily close below 62.10 right now to give us a new daily sell signal. Natural gas had a big reversal after Monday's pop yesterday. Inside day for natural gas, shouldn't kick it too much, but not, I don't expect it to go anywhere soon. A daily close below 285 would give us a new daily sell signal for natural gas. I still get a lot of emails about people who are peeved that I picked gold over crude oil. You know, I missed that big run up to $1,000. Oh my God, the end of the world. Well, listen, you know, it doesn't matter where gold is going to. If it's going to $1,000 or $2,000, it doesn't matter the dollar amount. It's always percentages. We're concerned about percentages, not dollars. Now, since the big move up started in gold, and yes, it has been a big move, as it has been in a lot of commodities, gold is up 14% off the lows. And so that's exciting for some people, but I took crude oil, and crude oil is up 42%. So I had a choice, energy or gold, and I took energy, I took crude oil, and it's all about percentages. That, you know, the fact that gold's getting closer to $1,000 is kind of irrelevant when you've got other opportunities on the table. Looking at the TSX, it's up testing 10,625 2 days in a row, hasn't been able to break through. On the downside, a daily close below 10,100 would give us a new daily sell signal. Looking at energy stocks, a daily close below 263 would give us a new sell signal. Financial stocks, 144. And gold, of course, is up testing the previous peaks. Gold stocks and gold are two different things, of course. We need a daily close below 326 on TSX Gold Index to give us a new daily sell signal. And last but not least, the Venture Exchange, a daily close below 1095 right now would give us a new sell signal for the Venture Exchange. Okay, that's all for Wednesday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Thursday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit TheUptrend.com.